In this class, let us learn current electricity. Let us consider a conductor of length L and cross-sectional area A. The conductor has free electrons. Let N be the number density of the free electrons, number per unit volume. So the total number of free electrons is capital N. That is equal to number density into volume. Volume is area into length of the conductor. When a potential difference is applied across the conductor, that is a cell is connected across the conductor, the electrons experience a force towards the positive terminal. So the electrons will move from one end of the conductor to the other end. This motion of the electrons constitute electric current. The electric current is defined as the charge flowing per second. Q is the charge flowing through the conductor, and Q is equal to NE, where N is the total number of electrons and E is the charge of each electron. The potential difference is defined as the work done to move unit charge from one end of the conductor to the other end. Unit of electric current is ampere and that of potential difference is volt. As the electrons experience a force, this force per unit charge is known as electric field. E is equal to F by Q. The potential difference V is W by Q. And W, the work done, is equal to force into displacement. L is the displacement of the electrons. So FL by Q. And F by Q is the electric field. So electric field into length. Therefore electric field is equal to V by N. That is, electric field is directly proportional to the potential difference and inversely proportional to the length of the conductor. And another term related to current electricity is current density. It is denoted by J. It is a vector quantity. And it is defined as the current per unit area, unit cross-sectional area. The metallic conductors obey Ohm's law. According to Ohm's law, the potential difference is directly proportional to the current. The current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference applied. So V proportional to I, or V is equal to a constant R into I. This constant R is known as resistance. The resistance of a conductor is directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to area. Therefore, R is equal to a constant rho into L by A, and the unit of resistance is Ω. The constant rho is known as resistivity and its unit is Ω per meter. The unit of resistivity is Ω meter. Reciprocal of resistivity is known as conductivity, and the unit of conductivity is Ohm raised to minus 1, meter raised to minus 1. Or it is also known as Siemen meter raised to minus 1. And now let us see the velocity of the electrons in a conductor when an electric field is applied. This velocity is known as drift velocity. A conductor contains free electrons, and the free electrons are in random motion. So the average velocity is zero. So the current in a conductor is zero. But when an electric field is applied or a potential difference is applied, the electrons experience a force, and the force experienced by the electron F is equal to EQ. And the charge of the electron is minus A, therefore F is equal to minus EE. E is the electric field and small letter A represents the charge of the electron. So the acceleration of the electron, A is equal to F by M, that is equal to minus EE by M. We are considering the motion of the electron in between two successive collisions. In between two successive collisions, the electrons travel in a straight line. So V is the velocity just before a collision, and U is the velocity just after a collision, or the initial velocity. And T is the time interval between two successive collisions. When we consider all the electrons, let us take the average value. The average value of the final velocity, it is known as drift velocity. And the average value of the initial velocity will be zero, because the electrons are in random directions after a collision. So the average value of the velocity will be zero. The average value of the time between two successive collisions is denoted by tau. Tau is the relaxation time. So let us substitute in this equation. Drift velocity Vd is equal to u value is zero. So A into tau, that is equal to, let's substitute for acceleration. So minus EE by M into tau. And the velocity is a vector quantity. So vector Vd is equal to minus, electric field is a vector quantity, EE by M into tau. And this negative sign shows that the velocity of the electron is opposite to the direction of electric field, or the electrons will move in a direction opposite to the electric field. And the electric field is V by L, so the drift velocity is directly proportional to the electric field. So it depends on the potential difference, and it is inversely proportional to the length of the conductor. And drift velocity is directly proportional to relaxation time, but the relaxation time is inversely proportional to temperature. So we can say that drift velocity depends on the electric field and the temperature. And this is the motion. The dotted line represents the motion of the electron under the electric field. The electric field is directed towards left, and the electron is accelerated towards right. Under the action of electric field, the electron reaches B dash instead of B. B is the position in the absence of electric field. So when an electric field is applied, electron produces a very small displacement in a direction opposite to the electric field. This type of motion is known as drift, and the velocity of the electron is known as drift velocity. Thank you.